I served you faithfully, yet you shackled my soul to this tomb. I curse you for denying me revenge beyond the grave.
I remember him. He was a nobleman who conspired to butcher a rival family, but was caught. His execution lasted 4 weeks.
We bear the same grudge against the faceless Tsar, mortal. I could be a powerful ally if you lift my curse. Together, we can destroy the remnants of House Lavinius!
Butchering a whole family? Sounds like an unfair deal for a mad ghost.
That family is long dead, Van Helsing.
Oh well. An ally always comes in handy, vengeful ghost or not. I don't really want to sound impatient, but you promised me a story about Lady Irina.
You must understand that I've kept this to myself for more than a century, so it's a little difficult to know where to begin.
Let's start with a simple question. Who is she?
She is my sister.
Your sister?
To be precise, my twin. How should I put it? Her evil twin? You know, it's a very Borgovian thing.
I might need some time to deal with this.
Traditional Borgovian family. I had ancestors with names like Impaler. We kept dungeons below our manor and worshipped the Dark God.
And Irina was the what? The white sheep of the family.
Yes. No wonder we didn't get along. I was ambitious, cool, and I loved it. I always played nasty tricks on them. There was that incident with the pony. You know. Can you just not talk about this until I destroy some monsters?
Be my guest. But then please continue.
Oh, I hate this dreadful place. This is where all my family members ended up after they died. We became the aristocracy of the Nightmare Hollow, which is one of the consequences of worshipping a dark god. Faceless one, we called it.
The Faceless One? And you didn't think it was worth mentioning this until now?
It's Borgovia! Everything and everyone here is faceless or grim or evil or something else that you find in the thesaurus when you run out of the convenient names.
And what was it like to serve the Faceless One?
It involved a lot of chanting in robes, altars of obsidian black candles, and some nastier practices too. But I'll get back to that later.
Chimera has returned from a successful hunt. Return to the lair to receive the spoils of the hunt.
sack of warm meat with a special necklace in his possession. Name the price.
That is just a chocolate necklace from an old hag.
What chocolate? Oh, of course. Chocolate. I get it. Will a crypt full of treasure be enough?
I still don't have any idea what you're babbling about.
To you, it's useless. To me, it's unearthly joy and salvation.
The old hag did say chocolate-coated biscuit sticks, right, Van Helsing?
Just hand it over. Whatever the price, no!
Here is your necklace. Now get out of my way.
You struck down House Lavinius. I devoured their essence and became more powerful than I've ever been. Time to show my gratitude by ripping out your feeble soul!
Welcome to the Second Circle. This is where the wealthy souls stay forever. You know, the ones who could afford to fill up their crypts with money during their mortal lives.
Makes you wonder why the ectoplasmoid proletariat wouldn't revolt against the oppressive immaterial regime.
Borgovia might be the guiding light in mad science, but some things just won't change around here that fast. And speaking of fast, let's get to one of those bridges quickly. Back to my story, then. There were tensions between Irina and me, the quarrels of the good twin and the bad twin. When I heard the whispers that on our birthday, my family would throw a ball in honor of her, her only, my wrath knew no bounds. I was an unbearable monster then. Can you imagine that?
I can't even picture you brimming with furious anger.
And that was what led to the most despicable decisions of my mortal life.
doomed to roam this shadow world for eternity? Speak your name and purpose.
My name is Van Helsing, and I'm here to destroy the Faceless Tsar.
I fought it through numerous incarnations, only to be struck down and banished here every time.
And how did you escape from this world to be born again?
I was released by a champion like you, who spoke my name. Oh, I had many.
Tell me yours then, and let's get on with this.
My curse is not to remember, but you can find them at places where I was laid to rest. Will you release me?
All right. I will release you by finding and speaking your name.
Choose carefully. Some of my names bear a terrible burden.
The enemy has captured one of our key personnel. We must send a rescue mission.
The tomb says, here lies Infernalus. A friend buried alive by the Eternal Tsar.
I'm bored. Shouldn't we hunt down something?
Cogs and lightning and steam. I can build it.
Thank you.
successful hunt. Return to the lair to receive the spoils of the hunt.
I really must hear the rest of your story. What happened on that fateful evening?
I decided that only I deserved that special occasion, and Irina didn't. Her plan was simple and clear. I gave her a potion that brought her to sleep. Then I slipped into her beautiful dress and went to the ball instead of her.
And your family realized they had been tricked and punished you?
It was worse than that. They didn't even notice I wasn't Irina.
I really don't like where this tale is going.
The tomb says, here lies Albus, the fool who dared the might of the Death God.
I can't do that.
Thank you. the tomb says, "Here lies Damnatus, crushed again and again by the Faceless One."
I sense something magical around here.
The ball, right. What I didn't know was that it wasn't for Irina or me. It was to be a celebration for the Faceless One, including a grand sacrifice.
Your evil family wanted to sacrifice the innocent Irina to their dark god.
Indeed. It's terrible, isn't it? My family was a nest of monsters. I wasn't any better than them. But we all paid the price. Yes, we all did.
They sacrificed you in her place.
When I realized what they were going to do, I panicked. I was shrieking. I told them that it was a mistake. And they laughed. And they cut off my head with the sacrificial silver axe.
I don't even know what to say. We'll meet again on Heavenly Grazing Grounds, my dearest pony. Your Irina.
returned. Seek my name, mortal.
Your name is Albus.
The name of Ascension. So, another cycle of my existence can begin. We will never meet again.
So you made a pact with my father to get away from here?
Yes. He didn't trust me, for obvious reasons. So he crafted the magical oath that binds me to your family, and that's all you need to know.
You should have told me this a long time ago.
I didn't want your pity. I still don't. But you were right. You have the right to know about this.
I'll skip the emotional monologue. But I'll be there during your family reunion.
Believe me, you'll need my protection more.
Thank you.
from the haunted forest.
aesthetic grace meets ancient evil. Some of these statues look more menacing than the inhabitants.
Your Chimera has returned from a successful hunt. Return to the lair to receive the spoils of the hunt.
For the Resistance!
It's been a while, little sister. Fate plays cruel jokes on us. Here you are, the lapdog for the Warrior of Light, repenting for your sins. And here I am, once an innocent soul, now the Acolyte of Darkness. All thanks to you.
Would you believe me if I told you that I was sorry?
Of course not. You are just playing tricks with me. What a hypocrite you are. Have you ever told your mortal master about the terrible deeds our family has done?
It wouldn't have been very ladylike.
Still the witty one, I see. Notice, Hunter. During our reign of blood, hundreds and thousands perished to please our protector, Kushai, the Deathless. Why would you turn against him now, sister?
You are insane. Kushai never existed. He was just a myth, a legendary magician. An excuse for our family to revel in violence.
That's so sweet. You really believe your childish nonsense? How could you be so blind? How could you not recognize the one behind the mask?
And now you are playing tricks with me. I won't fall for this, sister.
Enough. I don't care who he is. You can call him Prisoner Seven. The Faceless Tsar or the Deathless One. Whatever his name, I will destroy him. But not before I seal these tombs again.
what happened. All the darkness I carried around with me just fell away. I'm floating away. Away from this terrible place. I'm so sorry, Irina. I really am. Don't be. It's good to be free again, even if it takes me somewhere else. But for you, it's not over yet. My parting gift is a door to the heart of the Ink. Go to the Spectral Provinces. That's the source of the dark disturbance in the Ink. You might even find a way to the Faceless Tsar. Thank you, sister. It's such a shame that we must part like this. One last thing before I go, Katarina. Do you remember my pony? The one I stole from you? When I made you so angry?
I won't live to that curse! You'll never have a pony again! Sorry!
Oh, you just had to ruin it, didn't you? The ingate to the Spectral Provinces is open. But when my sister passed away, I felt another gate opening nearby. Maybe we should investigate.
And I can smell a familiar stench. There are vampires here.